Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's look at working with text files using command line functions and apps in the terminal. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So let's say you're in the terminal like this and you want to work with some basic text files. There's a lot of different commands that you should know. First, let's create a new text file. To do so, we're going to echo some text. We're going to use the echo command, and then we'll put some text in single quotes. This will simply just repeat the text. But if we use the same command, I'm going to use the up arrow to repeat the command, and I'm going to use greater than to send the result of this echo function to a file. So let's call this test.txt. Now I'm actually at the desktop, so you should see the file appear over here. So I'll hit return, and sure enough, there's the text file. Let's double click it to open it up in TextEdit to see what we got. So there you can see it just contains that text. Now what if we wanted to view that in the terminal? We can use the cat command. So I use cat space, and I'll type the name. Now I don't have to type it all out because there's only one file on the desktop. So if I type T and then hit tab, it'll fill the rest in since there are no other files that begin with the letter T. Now I hit return and it will show me the contents of that file. Now cat is short for concatenate. So what it actually can do is show us the results of several files one after the other. So let's rename this test file using the move command, MV. And I'm going to make test.txt test1.txt. Now you can see it changed names right here on the desktop. Let's create a new text file. I'm going to up arrow to go back to this, and I'm going to change the text here to this, and I'm going to have it save this out to test2.txt. So now you can see I've got two files, test1 and test2. If I do cat and test1.txt, I would get the contents of that file. But if I also add to the line test2.txt, it'll show me both files concatenated. I can send this to a new file. We'll call this test.txt. And it creates this new file here. If I open it up in TextEdit, I could see it has both there. So this is how I can merge files. I've merged two files here, but I could merge many more. Now a lot of times when you want to work with text files, you already have a text file. So in this case, I've created a new test file that is just a list of 500 random names. So let's work with this one in Terminal. Let's say I didn't want to see all of the lines of this file. I just want to see the first 10 lines. I could use the command head and type the file name. It gives me the first 10 lines. Tail and the file name will give me the last 10 lines. I can change the number of lines by using something like tail or head dash n and a number like 5. And then the name of the file. It now just gives me those 5 lines. Now if I want to view the entire thing, I can type cat and the name, but it's going to just scroll up 500 lines. Instead, I can use less. Less is a little app that's a viewer for you to be able to see text files. So less test.txt. And now I see all the lines, but it stops there at the bottom. I could use the arrow keys to go down and up and even spacebar to jump by page. So I could navigate through this file to see what's in it. I'll use Q to quit. Now with a lot of little terminal apps like this, there's a ton of functionality. So you want to use the manual, M-A-N, and then the name of the command, and then you get this full manual here telling you everything you can do with the file. I can hit return to go line by line or spacebar to jump through pages and read more about less or any of these other commands I'm using to see what they're capable of. Now let's really work with this file. We can use the sort command to sort a file so every line is sorted alphabetically. So sort and then test.txt, and it's going to just give the output right to the screen. So we get 500 lines scrolling up, and you can see they're in alphabetical order. Now if we wanted to output this to a new file, we can do sort, then the name of the file, then dash o, and the name of the new file. So sorted.txt. And now we can see we get this file here, which is a sorted list. You can look at the manual page for sort to find all sorts of cool things you can do with it, including be able to randomly shuffle the lines. So sort and then dash and a capital R and then test.txt Now we get those 500 lines but in a random order. And we can do it again and it's a new random order. There's also a command called WC which will give you a word count. Actually gives you more information than that. So here it tells us that there are 500 lines, 1,000 words, and 7,056 characters. Now what if we wanted to search through this? I can use grep to do a search using regular expressions. So let's look for the name Gary in this random list of names. And you can see it comes up with one line that has the name Gary in it. Let's do the same thing but maybe for Ben. And we'll see we actually have three lines. A Bentley, a Benjamin, and a Bennett. And in one case it's a last name. Now we can use SED if we want to actually change the file. So we include a command in this. S for substitute. And let's say we want to substitute every capital T with a exclamation point. Like that. And then we do test.txt. It'll give us the results here and you can see the T's were replaced with an exclamation point. You could do it for a group of characters and there's a whole bunch of other commands if you look at the manual for SED. Now you can send this to a new file but if you actually use SED with -i then it will actually do it in place. So it would change the file right there. So it's a little dangerous but it may be what you want to do in a particular case. A more powerful command for doing even more with text files is awk or awk. With things like grep, sed, and awk, the manual pages are huge and there are tons of websites that go into detail about all the different things you can do with them. But let's look at an example here. If I use awk with -f and then quotes around a space, it's going to look for spaces and it's going to break up the file by spaces. So maybe another type of file you might want to break it up by tabs or by commas or semicolons. And then it's going to output just the first element. So we know every name is a first name and last name. In this case we're just going to get the first name. So here if I hit return you can see it outputs all the first names. If I do the same thing but say give me the second element on each line it outputs all the last names. And here is a command that will do the same thing, break each line apart by spaces, but it's going to output the last name and then a comma and a space and the first name. Now what if you want to work with these files directly? Of course you can use TextEdit or a third party text editing app but there are two text editing apps inside of Terminal. One of them is VI and you can use this to go into editing mode here. I can use the arrow keys to move around and I can edit text. Now VI is a really complex text editor that dates back decades. The best reason to use VI is if you've already used VI before and you kind of had to become an expert with it. So a lot of people that were using computers in the 60s, 70s, and even 80s are pretty good at VI. But otherwise you want to skip VI and go with a much easier little text editor called Nano. That actually has little commands at the bottom so it helps you figure out what you're doing and it works a little bit more like a regular word processor like TextEdit would work. And then you can make changes to this file and save them and exit using little control commands and work on text files without ever having to leave Terminal. So there's a starting point for using the Terminal to be able to work with text files. Certainly commands like sed, awk, and grep are good reasons to work with text files in the Terminal. And there's no reason you can't combine these techniques with desktop apps. So in other words, work with the file in TextEdit to edit it, but maybe every once in a while use a grep or an awk command to perform special functions. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.